stopped beating. He died, literally died that morning in that classroom.
Son Carson knows he has a very unique story.
If we think about it, I died two times and I came back to life. How many people could say that?
The 15-year-old's tale of navigating this reality with whatever lies on the other side goes back a few weeks when he collapsed at Cordova High School.
I remember that whole day, but up until then.
After collapsing, Carson was unresponsive. Licensed vocational nurse Blaine Engbert and the school's resource officer Tracy Jacobs were some of the first people tasked with saving Carson's life.
And immediately went to do chest compressions. And the purpose of that is to keep the oxygen flowing through that's in your blood, to keep it flowing to the brain and to the other parts of your body.
It was pretty overwhelming. As a school resource officer, I became very attached to these kids, and it was pretty emotional when I found out that he survived.
After being rushed to the hospital, a doctor would tell Carson's mom that if it wasn't for the team of people helping him at the school, Carson wouldn't have made it.
If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have my son here. So I'm blessed to have them help my son.
After tests, it was learned that Carson suffers from Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. That's a condition where an extra pathway in the heart causes a rapid heartbeat.
We're still going to doctors and stuff like that.
And trying to figure out the best course of action.
Yeah.
At tonight's Folsom Cordova School Board meeting, those who helped save Carson were honored. Carson, whose sense of humor is definitely at peak performance, says his ability to die and come back to life will give him a leg up on campus.
Most likely. I'm gonna make it work.
He also requested to hold our microphone, which we had no objections.
Sure, you can hold.
Let's go!
All while he thanked those who helped keep him among us.
Thank you to everybody that saved me, that brought me back to life.
In Rancho Cordova, I'm Eric Rucker, Fox 40 News.